Welcome to Paint Pouring with Ron. In our last video, we had a look at some of the things you should keep in mind when you're getting your workspace ready for painting. If you missed that one, I'll put a link to it at the end of this video. In today's video, though, we're going to have a look at canvases. In particular, what you need to do to a canvas to prepare it ready for painting. If you like what you see today, please press the like button. And if you want to know more, please subscribe. Thanks. So, canvases. The first thing you're probably going to wonder is what canvas you should be buying for paint pouring. Well, in the end, it doesn't really matter too much. Most canvases will work. If you're made of money, sure, go and buy the diamond encrusted ones. But I can't afford them. On the other hand, don't buy the $1 ones from the cheap shop because you're probably getting what you are paying for. They might work, but again, they may not work. I tend to stick to the middle of the road canvases. A brand that I particularly like to use is the Montmartre brand of canvases. They've got various qualities in their range, but I go for their cheaper ones called the Studio Canvas. They come in lots of different sizes and also thicknesses. I like using the thin edge ones in particular for things like blooms and swipes. They also have the thick edge canvases, which I like using for flip cups or ring pours or other techniques that use heaps of paint. Now, when I buy a canvas, I need to make sure of a couple of things. Firstly, I need to make sure that it's primed. It will usually say on the front that it is primed. Most canvases these days are. Beats having to prime a canvas yourself. The second thing is to make sure that the canvas is level. I've gone through lots of trouble making sure my table is level, and I don't want to buy a canvas that's warped. It may look a bit stupid, but when I buy canvases, I lay them out on the floor in the shop. If they wobble, I don't buy them. They're warped. I make sure I buy ones that lie flat on the floor. Makes life a lot easier. Now, when you're going to use a canvas, of course, you unwrap it first. And then you need to test to see if it's tight or not. A good way to see if a canvas is tight is to tap it. If it sounds like that, like a drum, then it's nice and tight and it's good to use. Why is that important, you may ask? Well, with paint pouring, some techniques use lots of paint. And if your canvas is fairly loose, your paint will force the canvas down in the middle and your paint will pool in the middle. If it's nice and tight, like this one is, that's less likely to happen and you won't get any trouble with it while it's drying later. Now, what do you do if your canvas isn't tight enough? Well, in most cases, what you can do is get a spray can of water and just spray the back of the canvas lightly with water. You don't need to give it a bath. Just spray it lightly with water, rub it over with a paper towel, and then get a blow dryer and blow dry it. That will stretch your canvas, and most of the time it will work and your canvas will be nice and tight enough to work with. If it's still too loose, then of course you can use the stretcher bars that are normally supplied with the canvas. And it's just a matter of hammering them into the corners of the canvas in the slots that are provided there for you. The instructions are usually on the bit of card that comes with the canvas. Don't get carried away though, it's easy to overstretch your canvas and you end up ruining your canvas, particularly in the corners. What you just need to make sure is that it has a nice drumming sound like that, and then it's good to use. Now, what do I do to the canvas now before I start chucking paint on it? Well, if I'm just going to lie it flat on the table like this, and I pour my paint on it, it's going to be difficult to work with because I won't be able to easily pick it up to move the paint around. So I need to lift it off the table a little bit to make that much easier. Now, there's lots and lots of different ways of doing that. The way that I like to do it is by using some very large push pins stuck into the corners of my canvas. I got mine from my local Office Works store. They're huge and they give me just enough finger space underneath to make life easy when I'm pouring my paint on the canvas. What you also need too is something to protect the underside edges of your canvas with. I use some masking tape. In particular, I use the painter's masking tape to mask over the back of my canvas. I prefer using this because it doesn't stick very hard and it's easy to take off again when my painting has dried. Now, I'll just demo that a little bit for you so you can see how all of that works. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is flip your canvas over and tape the edges with your masking tape. I don't go to the very edge of the canvas, that may show. I just go to the inside of the canvas like so. Cut off the end. And then I go around the canvas like so. This. I mean, some people don't bother doing this, but I just think it makes your canvas look a lot tidier when you're done, especially if you're going to sell it. You like it to look a little bit tidy for the customers who get it. Okay, so I've taped it on. Right, and then I put the push pins in. So all I need to do, get my push pin. You'll find some pins are longer than others. If the canvas is really thin, I find the shorter ones, otherwise the pin may go through to the other side. But if it's a thick edge like this one, it doesn't really matter. Okay, so I'll just go to the edges here. Don't go right to the very edge because then it may interfere with the paint coming down the side. So I just come in a bit and we just hammer it in like that. Framing wood is always very soft, so the pins are easy to get in. If the painting is super large, you may put some in the middle, but this size is fine. So that's done. Now, if my table was level to begin with, this should now be level. To test it though, I've just got one of these little leveling things I found at Bunnings. I just go around the sides and I just make sure that bubble is more or less in the middle as I go around the sides. Now, because my table was level, the pins were all the same and the canvas wasn't warped when I bought it, it's ready to go, easy. But if you find that it's still not quite level, you can just pull the pins in and out a little bit, play with those until you get it level. The last thing you want is for your paint to slide off to one side while it's drying. Okay, so my canvas is now ready to go. As you can see, it's very easy now to get my fingers underneath and the canvas won't stick to anything while it's drying. So it's easy to carry around, move around, finish off nicely. So that's all you need to do really to get your canvas ready. Well, that's really all I wanted to go through with you today on today's video. It's not that difficult when it comes to preparing your canvas ready for painting. And I hope that some of the tips I've shared with you today really help you in your own workspace when you're being creative. In the next video, we're going to have a look at paints and pouring mediums. People people often have lots of questions about these, and I'm sure some of the things that I'll share with you, you will find useful as well. Until next time.